In this video, we're going to show you how to identify different types of media used in Zebra printers. It's important to know the media or supplies you are using because your printer settings must match the media you are using for your print job. Refer to the specification sheet for your printer to see which types of Zebra supplies can be used in your printer. The types of media you might use in your printer are continuous media, non-continuous media, direct thermal media, thermal transfer media, RFID media. Some media might be more than one type, such as non-continuous and direct thermal. No matter what type of media you use, you need to set the correct settings and calibrate the printer with your media before you proceed to send your print job. Refer to our video on calibrating your printer for more information on that. Continuous media comes in a plain roll that does not have any indication or separation or gap. When the printer is set to continuous media mode, the media sensor does not detect label length, but will only monitor for media out or paper out condition. While in this mode, there will not be any top of form indicators with continuous media. Non-continuous media has something to indicate where one label stops and the next one starts. The indicator can be gaps, notches, holes, black marks, perforations, or even combinations of these on the same label. Non-continuous web labels are individual labels on a continuous liner with gaps between labels. The width between labels, or the gap, should be from 2 to 4 millimeters. When using this type of media, you will need to set your sensor to gap notch and align the media sensor over the area where the labels are closest to each other. For non-continuous notched or hole media, you will also set the sensor to gap notch and align the sensor over the notch or hole, making sure to avoid the radius or edge of the hole. Non-continuous mark media has a black mark on the back of the liner or labels. This mark can go partway or all the way across the media. This type of media uses the reflective sensor to sense the black mark, so you must set your media sensor to reflective. Non-continuous perforated media has perforations that allow labels or tags to be separated from each other easily. You might use the media for tickets, sales tags, and so on. The media may also have black marks or other separations between labels or tags. Set your media sensor based on the type of separator used in addition to the perforation. In this example, you see the media with both a gap and a black mark. Mixed, non-continuous media will have more than one type of label separation indicator. You may choose which media sensing option works for your situation and calibrate for that option. RFID media is a special type of media with chips or inlays which can be read by RFID readers. RFID media is used for asset and equipment tracking, inventory management, theft prevention, and a wide variety of other uses. You can identify RFID media by the inlay located between layers of the media. As you identify the properties of the media you will print on, you will also want to know if you're using direct thermal or thermal transfer media. Direct thermal media are labels that do not need any ribbon to produce the image on them. The printing happens on the media or a label itself when it contacts the heated printhead, and a chemical reaction darkens the media in exactly the right spot and creates the necessary image. Such media can come in a form of continuous or non-continuous media. Direct thermal media is a good choice for labels that are not exposed to extreme conditions or are not expected to last an indefinite length of time. Many shipping labels are printed on direct thermal media. Thermal transfer media needs a ribbon to create the printout on the media. The heated printhead transfers the ink on the ribbon to the media. This makes a durable, long-lasting image on your label, tag, or ticket. It is important that your ribbon and media are compatible for the best results. The Zebra Supply Selector helps you pick the right combination of media and ribbon. In case you're wondering what type of media you have in front of you right now, you can check by doing what we call a scratch test. Use your fingernail or an object and draw a quick line scratching the surface of the media. If you see a visible black streak appearing, you can conclude that the media is direct thermal media. Ribbon is ink on a clear backing. The ink is transferred to media when it is heated by the printhead. Ribbon most commonly comes in black, but you can order it in many other colors. Your printer model determines if you can use ribbon rolls with ink on the outside or on the inside. Check your printer specifications to be sure. To determine which side of your ribbon roll has ink on it, you can perform an adhesive test or a scratch test. To perform the adhesive test, peel a label from its liner. Press a corner of the sticky side of the label to the outer surface of the roll of ribbon and peel it off. If you see flakes or particles of ink adhering to the label, you know the ribbon is coated on the outside. If you don't see anything adhering to the label, repeat the test on the inside to confirm the roll has the ink on the inside. To perform the scratch test, unroll a short length of ribbon. Place the unrolled section of ribbon on a piece of paper with the outer surface in contact with the paper. Scratch the inner surface of the unrolled ribbon with your finger and then lift the ribbon from the paper. If it left a mark on the paper, then you know the ribbon is coated on the outside. If ink flaked off on your fingernail, then you know it's coated on the inside. If no mark was left on the paper or your fingernail, flip the ribbon over and repeat the scratch test with the inside of the roll against the paper. The ink should transfer to the paper. Thanks for watching our video on identifying media and ribbon for your printer. Be sure to visit the Supply Selectors link below to get genuine Zebra supplies for your printer.